Can you do one song with E-Double, please?
I've actually listened to E-Double. He's a really good rapper. If you were to approach me to rap on a track, yeah, I totally would. I mean, he's sick.
Do you have anything set up for fan mail?
No, I can't really afford a P.O. box right now. I don't even know how much those cost, but I'm trying to keep my expenses low. I don't want to obviously give away my permanent address. That would be a little creepy. I guess I will definitely plan on something coming in, since people have asked me, like, you know, they want to send me like a greeting card and stuff like that, and I think that's really, really nice. So I will definitely set something up in the future.
What is your favorite Pokemon?
Mewtwo.
Queer.
Without a doubt, Mewtwo. Psychic Pokemon are the shit. Like, there's just no competition.
Electrical are just badass.
No.
All right.
No. Psychic Pokemon all the way. They rule. Like, Abracadabra.
I want a Pikachu. It. What programs do you use to make your dubstep? Plugins, VSTs, all that stuff. I'm learning how to make some dubstep now, but I'm new, really new, lol. But I'm using Ableton now or something, and Massive. If it can help me out, that'd be great.
I mean, you're pretty much good to go making dubstep then. If you've got those programs and Massive, like, you're good to go. I use ES2 and Logic Pro. It's definitely not the best, but I've tweaked it out to where, you know, I can get it to where it sounds pretty decent. But basically, I just go into these, you know, regular plugins and VSTs, and I just tweak them out to the point that I get the sound that I want in dubstep. But I'm highly experimental with the settings and stuff like that to, you know, just see what sounds best.
What is your favorite song?
My favorite song of all time is Clair de Lune by Debussy. When I, like, first heard that, I was just, like, just taken away. That is, like, my favorite song of all time. I don't think I've heard anything more beautiful than that song.
Can you scream / growl or just rap? If you could scream / growl, please make a video and let me hear. Would be cool to hear it from you.
I was a huge metalhead, like, when I first got to high school. Pantera, Metallica, Slayer, Meshuggah. Of course, I've always wanted to be able to, like, scream really, really well. I can't really do anything, like, that wouldn't hurt my voice, because even rapping too loudly sometimes hurts my voice. I can sometimes do like a really low growl, like when I, like in the Telmini track, like I try to do like a really low metal growl going like, here we go, like something like that of the nature, but I can't project it very well without it hurting. What you hear in the songs, if anything that sounds that metal, that's probably as metal as it's gonna get.
Hey, could you do a Flux Pavilion Cracks rap remix?
Maybe.
Is that it?
Yep, that's
it. That's what you're going to say?
That's all I'm going
to
say.
Which of your Zelda remixes do you like the best? And I noticed you reply to a lot of comments. How do you know which video gets commented on?
Well, my favorite one is Song of Storms. That is my favorite to perform. The triplet feel to it just makes it even that much more difficult, and I love to take on a good challenge. So it's like, that's got to be my favorite. The epic drop in that song, just like, it gives me chills when I listen to it by itself. As for how do I know that people comment on my videos, you can actually set up a notification system in YouTube and get emails for when you get comments. I have the time to, so I do it.
I'm hoping to do a parody, but I'm on Windows, so do you know what program I should use? And just in general for making music.
What would you suggest for someone to record on Windows?
I'm definitely going to say, like, for music in general, would be possibly best to use FL Studio. If you can't get anything for that, message me on my YouTube. I will get you the stuff for it. I mean, because I've had it and I couldn't get along with it. But if you're into doing music, then yeah, I'll give you that. And it's a really good project to use. Also, for editing wise, would possibly be Sony Vegas. I personally use Sony Vegas. It's the most, I know it's not easiest one to get, but it's pretty simple once you sort of get a good tutorial on it. If you're going to like use decent editing software, Sony Vegas is definitely it, because once you download it, you get like loads of plugins, and there's also more ones you can download, for example, like Twixter, Magic Bullet Lux. I mean, I can't get it for my computer, but my computer's got a crap graphics card, so I can't run Magic Bullet Lux. So, but yeah, that's basically it. Will you make a gaming channel or vlogging channel?
I'm pretty much going to put my vlogs on None Like Joshua Music, which is my backup channel. Gaming channel, though, I don't really play a lot of games, but if I were to start doing so, then I'd probably make an entirely separate gaming channel to do that.
What kind of deodorant do you use?
Old Spice Pure Sport. Nothing better, nothing worse. I am not sponsored by Old Spice in any way. That is actually what I use.
He's lying. What do you think of UK grime, if you've even heard of it, of course?
I heard UK grime for the first time when I was in high school. I had heard P Money, Wiley, Professor Green, stuff like that. The first kind of grime, anything close to like UK rapping, was The Streets that I had heard when I was in high school. And I freaking love The Streets. The beats are just freaking sick. Like, I love UK grime beats.
Oh, you rap over Trollololol.
No, I will not do that.
What, but if I could get you a dubstep remix, would you do it?
No, not even.
Are that. You what?
I get requests to do. I get requests to rap over Nyan Cat dubstep, and I even refuse to do that. No.
Yeah, you
no,
should totally do
not
that.
Happening. Not happening.
Sorry.
No, not happening.
Yeah. What about if I did a beatbox cover of it? Would you do it then?
Nope, not even then.
Asshole. My question is, do you take pride in your lip singing?
Yes. Yes, I do.
Does he mean the stupid shit you do during, in between raps?
Yeah, when there's like vocals on the track already, like singing. And then I do take pride in it. I don't even think I'm that good at it. I don't really care. I can't help it, really. Sometimes I'm actually singing with it, and I just cut out the actual audio during that part.
Did your friends and family support you when you first started out?
My dad had always supported me, you know, playing music since I got into drumming and whatnot. My sister was the one that actually got me into actually playing music first. Like, I was like interested, but I didn't really know what to start with. And she was just like, "Play the drums. You'll totally get laid if you play the drums." And I was like 9. I was like, "Yeah, sure, why not?" Even when they couldn't understand, like, rapping over dubstep, they didn't make any sense to them. But, like, they were just all for it. They were just like, "Yeah, do it. Go ahead." They've been supportive the entire way, and I'm really thankful for that. My mom was, like, the only one that was, like, when I first got into rapping, she was like, "Why can't you sing more? Why don't you sing? I don't like rapping. I like singing." I'm like, "I am not that great of a singer." They've bought most of my equipment that I have. You know, only recently did I start buying my own equipment. But yeah, I'm very, very thankful. They've been supportive the entire way, and I love them very much.
Hey, Josh, what color hair dryer do you have?
It's purple.
Okay. Are you serious? You actually have
no,
purple hair
I
dryer?
Don't have a hair dryer. My hair dry all the way.
Could you recommend any programs, preferable freeware and pretty or pretty cheap, for people, me, that want to start making music like dubstep and other electronical based music, trance, techno, hardstyle, etc.?
For freeware, Audacity is usually the one to start out with, but if you can get FL Studio, I would say definitely get that and start working with it if you want to start making really good music. If you want to get the cheapest, like, okay quality mic, a blue USB mic is usually the way to go.
How is it like to listen to your own voice? Most of the guys out there who listen to their voice cringe. Same with me. If I listen to a recording of my voice, I immediately stop the recording. Do you have that problem as well, or do you like your own voice?
I don't really care. I don't like listen to my own voice. I'm like, "Wow, this is so soothing." Like, but I'm not, I don't like cringe at it either. I'm not like, "Oh God, I don't want to listen to this shit." I'm just like, whatever. Like, I have to record my raps. I'm going to have to listen to it. But it's not like I listen to my own shit like recreationally. The only time I actually listen to my own music is when, usually like before a show, if I'm gearing up for a show and I'm actually going to play that song, I usually want to listen to it just so I can, like, you know, get the lyrics down, get the flow down and whatnot, and, you know what I did recording wise. But otherwise, I don't really care to listen to my voice unless I have to.
Once you go big, are you going to ditch your YouTube page?
I don't know how big I'd have to get to ditch my YouTube page, since there's a lot of big artists that are still, you know, on their YouTube page.
I was thinking about myself.
Exactly. So probably not. I mean, no matter how big it happens, it's like, how big is big to where you can't even like get on your YouTube page? Like, that's just freaking ridiculous. So no, no matter what happens, I'm going to probably stay on my YouTube page.
Hey there. I'm Stephanie. My question for you is, later on when you're more recognized, are you going to be doing that as your primary job, or is that going to be something on the side?
I'm kind of confused, because if I'm recognized in doing this, then I'm probably going to be doing that as a job. This whole thing right now has always been on the side, but now that it's kind of just taking off, it's definitely being considered as a job now. This is what I've been working towards, I've been putting my money in, I have been investing the most amount of time into. I would say it's definitely a job that, you know, may not be making like that much money, but it's definitely something worth investing into. And in the future, yeah, if I can have this as a job, of course, like this is just what I want to do. This is my passion. This is my music. This is everything I want. It's starting to move away from being on the side, and it's like smack dab in the middle now, where it's definitely about to verge into being a job. So I want to thank all of you for asking your questions. And if you have some questions that were unanswered in this video log / Q&A session, feel free to put them down below in the comment section, and I can get to it in the next Q&A session. Thank you very much. I'm really thankful for all the new subscribers, all the new friends. A bunch of new opportunities are coming my way. I'm forming a lot more collaborations, so look out for that, and be sure to go to nonelikejoshua.com to check out the new merchandise. All the merchandise designed by Ash here. It's freaking sick. And if you need any design work, we are on a non-exclusive agreement, so you're more than welcome to contact him. If you need channel designs, video editing, t-shirt designs, whatever you want, get...
Now, I can get basically any designs, everything from like YouTube backgrounds all the way up to desktop backgrounds, t-shirt designs, album covers, so on and so forth.
He does everything, and the only reason I love working with him is because he actually listens, he knows... He will get exactly what you want. I really, really appreciate how he listens. So subscribe to this channel and whatnot if you haven't.
Just keep supporting this dude. He's a fucking nutcase. All right, and he's. I'm surprised he hasn't been signed already. My voice is going. Sounds going in the fucking bloopers. I'm surprised he hasn't been signed already. I mean, it's kind of crazy.
So, peace out. Signing out.